Let's continue the conversation now with CNN politics reporter Eugene Scott. Good morning, Eugene. You know, you look at the Obama administration and its relationship, specifically President Obama's relationship with Prime Minister Netanyahu. It hasn't been good over the past 8 years, and this is just kind of an end. This is ending on an ugly note. The perception here is that President Obama did pretty much make a parting shot, kind of giving Netanyahu the finger on his way out the door.
Yes, based on what you just shared, this is not that big of a surprise. I think people would have liked to have seen things end more positively, those who are more sympathetic to conservative movements in Israel. But President Barack Obama has made it known repeatedly that he would prefer a two-state solution to what we have happening right now. And this is not a position that Prime Minister Netanyahu has shared.
Okay, you look at what U.S. Ambassador of the U.N., Samantha Power, said after abstaining from the vote. Listen to this.
Israeli settlement activity in territories occupied in 1967 undermines Israel's security, harms the viability of a negotiated two-state outcome, and erodes prospects for peace and stability in the region. Today, the Security Council reaffirmed its established consensus that settlements have no legal validity. The United States has been sending the message that the settlements must stop privately and publicly for nearly five decades.
Okay, so she says that the vote was consistent with the president's positions in past years, going all the way back at least to Ronald Reagan. So many people are saying, well, why the backlash now?
Well, the backlash now, I think it's in part because we do have a new president-elect in control. Will soon be in about 4 weeks, and Congress as well, that is definitely more sympathetic to what we are seeing coming from the Israeli government. President Barack Obama, was just mentioned, hasn't done anything significantly different from what past U.S. governments have done. But I think there are people who got behind Trump who would like to see a more right turn in Israel and would have liked to see President Obama and the U.S. government be sympathetic to that as things and towards the end of the year.
You know, many are wondering, you know, after watching what happened in Syria, in Aleppo specifically, why the UN went ahead and took this action and took it in such a way that you look at the chamber applauding when this resolution passed, but why the UN didn't take action, any condemnation about Syria. It could be part of the reason why you saw President-elect Trump jumping in and tweeting this yesterday, saying, as to the UN, things will be different after January 20th. Do you think this is a warning that Trump may pull financial support from the UN?
I think it's possible based on what he has campaigned on in the past. He's given reason to believe that he definitely thinks the United Nations is not spending money in the way that he thinks best benefits American interests and allies. He's also called on people to his team, especially his nominated ambassador to Israel that would be more sympathetic to a more right shift. And he thinks the direction in which Prime Minister Netanyahu wants to take the country is more consistent with his ideas for not only the UN, but U.S. and Israeli relations as well.
All right, Eugene Scott, thanks so much for waking up early with us and giving us your perspective.
Thanks.